Imagine you are in a big tent. This is kind of what a yurt is, but it's furnished, so we're on a bed. And I had a roommate when I was living in this tent. And one day in the summertime, it was like 4, 5 a.m. The sun was already out because it was the summer. And my roommate is in like a bathrobe, and he's opened the door, and he's outside, and he's like, "Daniel, come look." And so I roll out of bed and get on my slippers and walk outside too. And we see this huge hill of like grass behind us, and there are horses just grazing on the hill. And we're like, "What?" They're just walking from left to right across our view, just horses like nibbling, going forward, nibbling, and going forward. And shucks, this was the first morning I was in Mongolia, and that really just started me with this idea of where am I? Where am I? And so I'm Daniel Lang. I graduated from the University of Nevada, Reno in May 2019, started Peace Corps in June 2019, and I've been in Mongolia teaching English since all that time until now. And I'm visiting the US for a Christmas period and wanted to talk a little bit about my first 7 months in Mongolia. At the university, I studied Chinese, I studied English and communications, and I really wanted to travel after graduating. I had already done study abroad programs in China. I really loved them. I was already pretty good at Chinese. And I decided that I wanted to figure out if I liked teaching English full time. And Peace Corps had a program for teaching English. I also did not want to pay for my travel. I like scholarships and grants, and Peace Corps pays for the travel. So I decided I would apply to Peace Corps, see if they would accept me into some sort of English education program, and I applied for Asia. So I said I felt I would be qualified for China, but I also felt open to wherever they thought I would be most suited for, I could go there too. And that's something that I think is really special about Peace Corps compared to certain study abroad or teaching abroad programs, that at the heart of it, Peace Corps will place volunteers where they are most needed if you are open to that. So I love that about Peace Corps. As for general expectations then, when I was chosen to go to Mongolia, I had heard from volunteers who are currently there that we might live in these ghers, as we call them, the yurts. And I was kind of worried at first because I thought that would be kind of cold, especially in the winter time. It does get very, very cold in Mongolia during the winter. But luckily, I found out that most volunteers don't live in the tents. It's kind of like if you are extremely motivated and believe you would survive it well, and you could, and that would benefit your service, then you can ask for one. But for me, when I had arrived in Mongolia, I said, "I will live in one if it makes me volunteer as a better volunteer." And I wound up being assigned to an apartment, so I haven't even had to worry about those things really. So, as for Peace Corps as a group, the goal of Peace Corps has three main goals. The first goal is that Peace Corps volunteers help provide qualified workers to whatever the host country has asked for. So Mongolia asked for people who can help with English education, which is why I work as an English teacher. Then the second goal of Peace Corps is cultural exchange. So I will share a bit about American culture with Mongolian people, and Mongolian people will teach me about their culture. And this is central to Peace Corps. There's a lot of big cultural exchange on this person-to-person level. And then the third goal of Peace Corps is the one I'm fulfilling right now, and that's teaching Americans about Mongolian culture and what it's like to live in and be in Mongolia. So those are the three overarching things about Peace Corps, and I love how when someone becomes a Peace Corps volunteer, they begin with an immersive type of cultural education. So I began Peace Corps knowing no Mongolian, and I learned a lot of Mongolian in the first 3 months. I lived with a host family, and sometimes Peace Corps volunteers will even do their service with a host family. For me, I live alone in an apartment now, but during the summer I had a host family. That was really great for just a 100% language immersion, as well as just getting used to what's it like having a Mongolian mom and dad, a Mongolian brother and sister, and how do we navigate that. So I had a Mongolian family, really helped me with my immersion, and within my first 3 months of very rigorous study, I was able to get to a level of Mongolian that it actually took me about 2 years of Chinese studies to get to in non-immersive environments. So being in that completely surrounded cultural environment is something that any Peace Corps volunteer will get through their training, because that is an essential goal of Peace Corps, that we ourselves as volunteers really understand the culture well. So that was the beginning of my service. And then I've been in Mongolia now for 7 months total, and I have just loved the opportunities I've had to learn about the culture and integrate in it, as we call it. And the biggest, I guess, triumph and difficulty for me has always been about communication. And you might think at first, okay, language is step one. And you would be right. I think that learning the language was one of my biggest challenges, where like the first few days someone would say something to me and I have no idea what they're doing, but then they'll like gesture, like, go here, but in Mongolian, and eventually I would get the words to understand what they're saying to me. And when I started to understand what they've been saying, those felt like real achievements. And I think anyone on any study abroad program can relate to that, of beginning knowing little or very little, and then moving up and gradually understanding more and more to the point where one generally gets what's going on around them. I found that was something really special for me. And when I first arrived to the university where I teach right now, even just getting to know my colleagues, understanding how I could help them, where they came from, and what my students needed, all of that was a new hurdle, a new challenge. And now I can say I've gotten to the point now where I feel very good about those relationships, where I've even helped students apply to study in the United States. Like, it goes both ways. And I think that for someone who loves to serve and help people, something like Peace Corps is, that's the whole name of the game. It's not a program where we're necessarily getting paid a salary. It's we're getting paid enough to live by at a living standard that's like everyone else who lives in the area. The actual amount of money I make is pretty close to the Mongolian minimum wage, actually. So it's very comparable to how people normally live. So I've only begun my service. I've only been in it for 7 months, and the total commitment is 27 months. So it's very new and very exciting, and I'm sure there will be more challenges. But the biggest one for me that I've always been working with is just keeping in touch with people, like whether they are moving on from college or moving on to new cities. It can sometimes be isolating, living alone in a different country for so long, where sometimes I just don't have work for a while, and I'm like, what are people doing at home? And so at pretty much my 7th month, I got some new internet, so I can now video chat with people, and I can do videos, so I'm excited that maybe in the future, if people are interested, I could do video calling or vlogs if people are into that. But so far I've done blogging, and that is at daniellang.me, so daniellang.me, and you can read a bunch of stories about my antics in Mongolia and how much I've learned and grown, and I plan to continue doing that. But the biggest social media in Mongolia is Facebook, and so I'm on that, not all the time, but with the time zone conversion with the US Pacific, basically in the morning in Mongolia, it's nighttime in Nevada, and then nighttime in Nevada, it's morning in Mongolia. So I'm quite happy to do video calls and such at those hours. I do that with friends. And when I know that people in the US understand what I'm going through, or when I know that my fellow friends in Mongolia understand what it's like for me as an American living in Mongolia, those are the moments where I feel like, yes, I am making progress, things are going well. And like any kind of program abroad, I feel like there's so many perspectives one gains from their time abroad. And I hope that if you have any questions, you will reach out too. Okay, I'm going back to Mongolia in a week. Let there be questions. All right, yes, there is a question.
All right, if I was interested in joining the Peace Corps, what's the best way to get in contact? Like, who should I contact to try and make it all happen?
The best thing about Peace Corps is that they have recruiters who are local, and if you just go to the Peace Corps website, they have a button like find your recruiter, and Peace Corps actually recommends you find the local recruiter, talk to them. I emailed mine and asked like, what should I do? And recruiters are amazing because they will set you up with how to prepare your resume correctly, how to prepare your interview correctly, because Peace Corps really does have some specific things they look for. For me, they actually requested a 3-page resume, which is really long. But what I love is that they help you become the kind of person that they're looking for in a Peace Corps applicant, and they also help you figure out how to decide whether your skills are useful for Peace Corps. So for me, I was thinking about, okay, I really like education. So I thought of all the different experiences I've had in education, but let's say I was also interested in health or agriculture. I could add all the experiences I've also done in agriculture, and I could ask Peace Corps then during the interview, okay, I like education, I like agriculture, take a look at my skills and tell me where you think I'm most qualified for. And so that's a really good way that when you're applying, if you tell them what you can do, they will tell you what you should do. Hope that answers your question.
Yeah, thank you.
Anything else? Okay, joyful, joyful. If you have more, you can reach out to me. I'm on the Facebook at Daniel Lang. I look like this probably if you look at my pictures. And I look forward to wishing you well in the future and right now. Happy studies, happy life. Goodbye.